What would happen if we simply melted the chocolate and cast it without pre-crystallizing it? Would we achieve the same shiny finished product or not? Let's give it a try. Here's a sheet with some paper on it. I've melted the chocolate without pre-crystallizing it and will now pour it on the sheet. Let's let it harden for a while. A few hours have passed and finally the chocolate's finally starting to solidify. It's taken a long time to do so. And what do we see? The chocolate looks dull and unappetizing. It melts easily. Let me show you. And sticks to the paper. It's not hard enough. It's rubbery. Its structure is grainy. And there are spots on it. Now I've carried out the same test with pre-crystallized chocolate, so we can compare both results. And what do we see? This chocolate comes off the paper easily. It's hard, in just a few minutes, has a nice crunch, a nice equal color and a satiny sheen. How come? The secret lies in the cocoa butter. It has to be crystallized in the right way. When cooling down, cocoa butter can crystallize in different ways. Only one type of crystallization is the right one and will yield the right properties of chocolate. Pre-crystallization means you have to ensure that the melted chocolate crystallizes in the right way. Hard chocolate contains these crystals. So if we chop up hard chocolate into small pieces, cut it up or use chocolate chips and add it to the melted chocolate, then we're pre-crystallizing the chocolate. It will harden in just a few minutes, will have the ideal gloss and the right hardness and shrinking force. This may sound like a lot of theory, but what does it really mean in practice? Let me show you.